and welcome to Pebbles channel. So we are talking about the science for standards 3 and 4, and we have seen about the plants and its uses not only for humans but for animals as well, and how the plant prepares its own food, that is the leaves prepares its own food with absorbing carbon dioxide and sunlight, and the plants breathes in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen that is used for humans and animals to breathe in, and the different parts of the plant, that is the root which grows below the ground and the shoot that grows above the ground. Next is about animals. So every side that we turn, we see animals, and animals adapt themselves according to the environment in which it survives. And there are certain animals that survive in cold countries, certain animals like the camel that survives in the desert, and it has a hump on its back in which it stores the excess water to use for later use. And hence it is known as the ship of the desert. And the hooves of the camel is designed in such a way that it is able to walk on the sandy ground, and it is more accustomed to the sandy ground rather than on a tar road, whereas the other animals find it difficult to walk in the deserts because of the large amount of sand. So next we were talking about the types of animals and its habitats. So today we will be seeing about the terrestrial animals and what do you mean by terrestrial animals. So animals that live on land are known as terrestrial animals. So there are animals that live on land, animals that live in water, animals that live in the cold regions, and animals that live on trees, that is your birds. So we are going to see about the terrestrial animals. Animals that live on land are known as terrestrial animals. For example, is your elephant, your cat, dog, lion, and camel. So these are all the animals that live on land. And most of the land animals have legs to move and lungs to breathe. So if you take the land animals, most of them have legs to move and lungs to breathe. But in the case of a snake, it is an exemption. It does not have legs to move, but instead crawls on the ground. So snake is an exception, as it does not have legs, it crawls to move. They have a well-developed nervous system. So just like humans, animals, the terrestrial animals, that is animals that live on land, have a well-developed nervous system and sense organs. So we have already studied about the five sense organs, that is your eyes, your nose, your ears, your tongue, and your skin. So these are the five sense organs. And the eyes give us the sense of seeing, the nose the sense of smell, the tongue the sense of taste, the ear the sense of hearing, and the skin the sense of touch. So these are the five sense organs, and just like humans, animals are also having these five sense organs. So they have a well-developed nervous system and sense organs to sense changes in their surroundings. So in the case of danger, with the help of its sense organs, an animal is able to know that there is danger appearing in front. So it is able to know what danger is about to come. However, climatic conditions are not the same everywhere. So the weather keeps changing. In some places it is very hot. Example is a desert, such as desert, while at some places it is very cold, like your polar regions, such as the Arctic. Thus, adaptations in animals also vary according to the climatic conditions of the place. So, there are certain places that are very hot, that is your desert areas, and certain places that are very cold, that is the polar regions like the Arctic. And animals are able to adjust itself according to the climatic conditions. Animals that live in hot deserts have thick skin and very less air on their skin to protect them from the heat of the sun. So, according to the place in which it survives, their skin of the animal is designed in such a way. For example, the animals that lives in the desert, that is your camel, have very thick skin and very little hair on its body in order to safeguard its skin from the penetration of the sun's rays. So, animals like camels have a hump on their back that stores fat. So, the hump on the camel's back stores fat. So, this is about the terrestrial animals. So, animals that live on land are known as the terrestrial animals, and these land animals have legs to move and lungs to breathe. But in the case of the snake, it is an exception. It does not have legs, but instead crawls to move. And these animals have a well-developed nervous system and sense organs to sense the changes in their surroundings. But the climatic conditions for each place varies. For example, we have very hot places like the deserts and very cold places like your polar regions, that is your Arctic. And the skin and air of the animal is developed in such a way so as to adjust according to the environment. For example, we've seen the camel. So, the camel's skin is very thick and it has very little hair on its body in order to protect it from the sun's rays. And the camel has a hump on its back wherein it stores excess fat. So, this is about the terrestrial animals.